sorry, you guys. Just a reminder, we do still have drink specials. $5 Williams.
Yeah.
Rum, Coke, and cherry juice.
Yeah.
And $4 beers, Miller High Life, and SPF 50/50. So we'll get you some. Up next, Piere Escargot.
I'm Piere Escargot. Bonjour, comment ça va? I ain't my real name. I got Lawrence. That's an alias. But I got two brothers, David and Dominic, and people asked how to get the name Piere, and I was like, I think my mom was drunk. It's either that or I was abandoned. Like, some people say adopted, but you can't have one without the other, so. I know what it is. You can't find something for one lost. But no, I had my mom do try to get that name, and she was like, that's what the fuck I felt like calling you. I was like, fair. You know, I thought it was because, you know, she wanted me to have a white name instead of the right name. So that's like when I apply for jobs, they don't just see my shit and throw it in the trash with a name like DeAndre Jackson. They see Piere Escargot, they're like, oh, we got a French guy in here. They come out looking at everybody in the room and just not the one black guy. And I'm like, hola, como estas, amigo? I'm like, you got a French name, Willie. My son little spell, CCC. But I asked my mom who's most recently which one of us was her favorite. And I think most parents would like dodge that question or give you a political answer and like, I love you all equally. She's like, nah, yeah, not my mom. She looked me dead in the eye and I was like, well, it's not your ass. I was like, I figured, I'm a middle child and she often would forget my name. Like when she would call all the kids for summoning is what we would call it. She's like, David, Dominic. Boy. I'm like, it's the only other one you have. Like, she called me the dog's name once. She's like, come here, Hercules. I was like, I'm skinny. I'm not even strong. That wasn't even a good mistake to make right there. You know? And I said, it's probably my little brother, you know, because he found God and got married and gave her first grandchild. She says it's not him, but she's always holding that baby, though. I'm like, I hear what you're saying, but I know what you mean, too. I remember I first started hanging around white people when I moved here to Georgia. I'm from Oakland, California, and I've never seen so many white people in one area. Like, not even on TV. Like, Saved by the Bell was as many white folks as I've ever seen. And then I remember I came out here, I was the only black guy in my class. It was a culture shock. You know what I'm saying? People used to come up to me, and like, I started getting interested in white women. I remember the first girl I dated, her name was Emily, of course. Ain't a black girl's name. And, Emily, she was like, can I touch your hair? And I was like, why? She's like, I just want to see what it feels like. And I was like, I thought about it. She's never met a black guy or been this close to touch one, so she just wants to see what it feels like. I get it, I guess. You know, I was like, if you never met a caveman before, you'd be like, bro, are you really like, I'm not going to get you over the head. And they just asked those questions. I thought they were like, bro, are you really like, strong? You know? But you know, she was like, let me feel your hair. And I was like, bet. And she was like, oh my God. And I was like, what? I thought she was going to say it was nappy. But she was like, it feels like carpet. I was like, carpet's cool because hard ones are uncomfortable. So I felt her hair and I was like, oh my God. She was like, what? I said, this feels like good credit. I think I love you. And I told my mom I started dating this girl named Emily. She told me I had jungle fever and I thought that was like something you need to go to the hospital for. This was like before Google. She said, boy, you got jungle fever. And I was like, is that why I get all hot and bothered when I see Emily? She's like, no. But he was talking about aggressive women. I remember the first aggressive woman I ever had was a white woman, so her name was Rebecca with a K. One of those people. Rebecca, she, you know, it was one of those things, like, she was out of my league. And I was kind of shocked that she was giving me a chance anyways. Like, I threw a ball up from half court and went in. I was like, fucking right. She came over, you know, she said, I'm coming through, you know. So I got home, cleaned the whole apartment up. You know, I vacuumed, did the dishes. I got a bottle of Crown, a bowl of some snacks, candles, like the shebang, besides like the Kroger roses. I was ready, you know what I'm saying? She was like, I'll be there in 10 minutes. So I went to, like, in the hallway, did like 30 push-ups real quick. You know, you do like 10 pull-ups, but tighten up real quick. You know, when they hug you, you gotta be like, yeah, you know? You know, so I wanna be writing on tight, you feel me? So she knocked on the door, she opened the door, she had on like a gangster bun, like hair up in it, like we're ready to go to work. She was in gym shorts and a spaghetti strap t-shirt. And like the ass was hanging out of the bottom of her pants, and I was like, oh. She walked right in and was like, hey, what's all this? And I was like, she also, I was 21, she was like 27, so she was with the shits, man. So she came in, she was like, what is all this? And I was like, well, I thought grabbed a bottle, was like cracking open with her mouth, bit over on the table and said, now what? I said, my check's mixed! It was the money buddy, bro. Like, you know, the $6 bag with the chocolate peanut butter powder. I had carpet, bro. And she knocked the whole shit on the floor. It was gonna get everywhere. And I then asked her to grab a broom. I said, you ain't got no coming home training. And she was like, are you serious? I was high as a rat pussy. And I was waiting to eat those money buddies after I ate the pussy. You feel me? Because you gotta play chess, not checkers. So I was gonna eat that and have a snack and come right back and hit it from the back. You feel me? I ain't gonna light yet, but I'm gonna go ahead and wrap this up. It's going pretty well. Before I go, I want to give you guys some light humor. It's a Bill Cosby joke, so it's not that heavy. I mean, we all know what he did by now. You know, you saw the movie. You know, the little double tape. But Bill Cosby, you know, clearly he's a rapist. He did his thug deals. You know, he tried to get some sneak dick, whatever. It's not the best way to go about it. I said, when Bill Cosby went to court, the lawyer's like, you want to talk? And he was like, yeah, I can defend myself. And he was like, well, what are you going to say up there? And he was like, how did these women know I raped them if they were asleep the whole time? Well, that's kind of like how he know I broke into his house. I only stole the TV. And the lawyer was like, well, that's not going to work. The detective come in and said, you know why we know you did it, Bill? He was like, how do you know? Because the proof was in the pudding. Because he had pudding and popsicles.